Hey, hello everyone, and welcome to another Power Platform video. I know it's kind of different because I'm talking in English, but yeah, I was thinking like this feature, the feature that I'm going to show you, is really, really good, and that's why I am doing it this video in English because I have people from United States as well, and yeah, that's the main reason. So what I'm going to present to you. This new feature allows you to control your Dataverse space. And the reason why it's really, really amazing to have it's because in many projects that I was doing in the past, it was kind of really hard to measure how many Dataverse space I will need and then control that the application that I'm building, it's going to respect that that estimation in Dataverse, I mean. I were facing a lot of troubles in many companies because of that. Let's say in some company I was starting a project, we buy some licenses to get storage in Dataverse, and then for some reason that storage was reduced, and the reason why it was because there were another project that was taking that space, that storage in Dataverse. So it was really difficult because you didn't have the chance to locked or just limit that that amount of Dataverse storage. So now the good thing is like Microsoft recently deployed an option, and then you can now control or limit that storage in Dataverse. So how can you do that? It's really easy. The first thing you can do is go over this gear icon in the top, and then click over Admin Center. Of course, this is a feature that an admin can control, or maybe you can just type directly admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. And the next thing that you have to do is go over billing, this billing option in here, and then type licenses. In here, you will have the option or the chance to double check your Power Apps licenses, Power Automate, Power Pages, Copilot Studio. There are now a lot of things in Copilot Studio that you can control over that option, but now I would love to focus on this Dataverse because again, what I am loving about this feature, the one that recently appears in here, is because that today we have the chance to manage our capacity. If I click over here, you will see a list of environments created, and then the lovely thing is that if you click over these environments, whatever you wanted to manage or change, you will see the options to add that limit. So let's say, for example, you know that you have one environment created for one project, just only one project, and you buy 10 licenses, and you know that your application in the future will be using just 10 MBs of storage. So now, what you can do is go over this option, then add your storage. If you think that you will be needing the entire amount, you can just pick in here, add the limit. Or maybe if you wanted to use files, also you can add the limit in here. And of course, for logs. So you are understanding how this is working and how beautiful it is right now. So now you have the control about your capacity. You have the control about how much you will spend in Dataverse storage on your projects. So, thank you so much, Microsoft. Thank you so much, product team, because this will really help for all the admins to try to measure how much storage you will need in the future. And of course, try to control your applications in terms of storage, because at the end of the day, you have to pay for it. So, that's one thing. And the second thing is that now you can also add your billing policy in here. And if you don't want to spend, how can I say this? Because at the end, you will spend money on this. But if you want to bill over Azure, so because you are a company that is using Azure to do your billings, you can also create a billing policy in here and attach that billing policy to your Azure resources. And then of course, you will pay for your Power Platform resources using Azure. So that's how this pay-as-you-go billing plan works. And how can you create one of those? If you close it. In here, and you go to manage, billing, plan, you will find, as you find in here, as you're seeing in here, I'm sorry, these are billing options that I have created. But you can hit over this new billing plan and then select Azure subscription, add a name, whatever the name you wanted, select your subscription in Azure, of course, and then select the resource, the Azure resource group that you have to create. And then if you select it, you can pick which one of the products of Power Platform you wanted it, in this space, pay as you go, and then you can go for it and then create it. And that's it. It's really easy. Of course, to see that subscription in this billing plan, what you have to be is a user to access to your subscription, the Azure subscription. If you have a user that doesn't have access to your Azure subscription, you will not be able to see this option in here. So make sure about that. And yeah, that's it. It's really easy. And now you have a lot of options to control about your billing, to control about your data storage. And again, thank you, Microsoft, for this. It's really, really helpful. And I hope this will help you as well, team. So thank you so much for being here. Listen to me in English, making mistakes. But yeah, I always try to do my best to share content. And hopefully you can implement this in your companies. And if you like it, if you find this video useful, please do subscribe. Please make a comment or give me a thumbs up. So thank you so much. I will see you in another video in English, hopefully. See ya.